Welcome to the 2023 USCA Golf Croquet National Championships being held at the Chesapeake Bay Croquet Club in Hartfield, Virginia. Your tournament director is the USCA President, Damon Bidencope. We are, of course, the official YouTube channel of the United States Croquet Association, which is charged with developing croquet in all its various forms all across the country. Don Oakley has been developing croquet in the U.S. for decades, even though he's from Toronto, Canada, and his croquet store by Oakley Woods can provide everything you need from starting a club to becoming a world champion. The Chesapeake Bay Croquet Club, under Macy White's guidance, is now the largest croquet facility in the world. Those eight courts to the right have been established for 4 or 5 years now and are playing beautifully. The 16 newer courts to the left have their first season this year and are playing nicely, but have a little ways to go. And lastly, I need to mention Chris Barley, our other sponsor, going on 2 years now. His assistance is very much appreciated. This round of 16 match and championship flight features Ellie Griffith, a delightful distraction when she came on the scene with Matt Griffith several years ago, and now a bona fide championship player in her own right. She lost her first game in this match to Sherif 7-3, and now they start game two in their best of three. Sherif Abdelwahab truly needs no introduction. More than 20 national championships and a major force in U.S. rules, AC, and especially golf croquet. He's even won a couple of nine-wicket nationals and is the only person I know to have done a sextuple peel in American rules. Looks like the knockout's being held on the eight established courts that have been mature for quite a while. The 16 newer ones still have a little ways to go. Set up first and clear second is only a loose rule. Blue's hoop shot is guaranteed with good travel down to hoop two, so he's going to unload both barrels on this one. Thank you. Missing 2 3-footers at hoop one against Sherif does not bode well.
This hoop is hot.
She could try to bump black into position here, maybe covering red shot on black with blue. So, using the tennis analogy, Ellie had first serve with blue. Sherif broke serve at hoop one, and now Ellie's playing catch up the rest of the way. Thank you. It's red to play. So they recognize the error, and Ellie has the choice of letting him put yellow back and play the correct ball, which is red way over here on the west boundary. Or she can leave yellow where it is, but make him swap it for red, which I think is the right choice, because if she does replace and replay, then he has both of his balls in action right away. And now Ellie plays black, the correct ball in sequence after the ball that Sherif should have played, which was red. It's comforting to know that even the best of the best can get confused. Looking grim for the chances of an upset here. This hoop needs to be pounded in a little bit. I'm not sure why he's putting red on the east side of this hoop. On the other side, he could have cleared blue long if it misses the hoop. She's clawing back, but she's going to have to learn to hit odd-numbered hoops harder so they get down to the next hoop. Get her a twofer, especially when she's behind. Now all Ellie has to do is make all the rest of the hoops.
Yeah.
There's a start.
I said that first.
So Sherif gets it done, 7-3, 7-4 over Ellie Griffith to move into the quarterfinals against Damon Bidencope, who beat Matt Griffith, Ellie's lesser half. Give us a like, subscribe. Thanks again to our sponsors, the USCA, Chris Barley, and of course, Don Oakley and the Croquet store by Oakley Woods. Everything you need from beginner to championship croquet.